people. It takes a long time. It's not easy. You have to choose a word very carefully. See, there's a lot of factors to be considered. Weight, balance, strength. It takes a lot of thinking out. Then you cut, you plane, you carve, you smooth out all the rough edges. But I say, you have to be patient. You can't rush things because it has to be right. Then there's the rigging, the mask, the cells, the paintwork. You have to do all of that to one day you think to yourself, this is as good as I can make it. And it's ready. So you take it upstairs, run the bath, and get in. And suddenly, there's thousands of people lining the sides of the bath. They grapple for vantage points, crowding into salt dish, and climb up tower rails. Some have even taken to the water, clinging onto floating sponges and rubber ducks. They will jostle for a better view, all eyes fixed on a little boat. You lower gently into the water. She sets off, slowly, majestically, edging herself nearer towards the taps. And now, you hear the cheering of the crowds. They're waving flags, holding up children, hats are being thrown, and tugs down their sirens from champagne bottles. It's a triumph. It's...
No! Are you going to be in there all day? Other people want to use the facilities occasionally.
When you make a boat, it takes a long time. It's not easy.
Jam sponge!
Jam sponge!
Tea cakes!
Tea cakes!
Scones!
Scones!
Iced buns!
Iced buns!
Marzipan and chocolate ghetto!
Marzipan and chocolate ghetto!
And lemon fancy!
And lemon fancy!
Oh, it looks wonderful, Mother!
You don't think it's a shade ostentatious?
No, Mother.
I don't want your young lady to think we're showing off.
Oh, she won't, Mother.
I don't want anybody thinking that we are...
Vulgar!
She keeps him away a shallow in a pretty cabinet. She says, just like Marie Antoinette, the building and the remedy, the rich job of infinity, it's an invitation you get. Happy heart, cigarettes, well versed in etiquette, extraordinary night, she's a killer queen, got body to the teeth, dynamite, laser beam. Thank you.
Thank you.
And this is my other brother, Shep. And his wife, Mrs. Shep.
And your father, Jesus?
Mr. Noah is busy this afternoon.
He's fully occupied.
I don't want to be detained.
Otherwise engaged.
I was really looking forward to meeting your father, Jacob.
Yes, it's a shame. Cake! Oh, yes, I love cake. It's very nice.
You always have plenty of cake in the house.
I always say to Shem, a man who is able has cake on his table. I always say that, don't I, Shem?
Well, judging by the cake on this table, I say Mr. Noah is very able indeed. Well, yes, and I say a man of a make. Has a table full of
Yes, I think so, Mr. Belmondo.
Well, are we or aren't we?
Yes, we're all here.
Transfer Trading International Strategic Assessments and Financial Policy Review Board's meetings declared open at
3:28. No, 3:29.
Beckwith, what is the time?
3:29, ma'am. It was 3:28. When I was looking at my watch, it was 3:28. But then when I was looking at my watch again, it became 3:29.
To continue, at our last meeting held on... Held on, Beckwith!
February the 29th, ma'am.
February 29th, it was reported that last year's annual budgets were...
It's here somewhere, ma'am.
Beckwith, there's no use it being here somewhere. Here somewhere is not where I want it.
No, ma'am, I'll just... Here it is.
February 29th, it was reported that last year's annual budget was...
29 billion.
Fell short of the expected interest quota charges in the second quarter to the tune of... To the tune of Beckwith.
Hold on a sec.
What did you say to me?
When?
Just now. What did you say to me?
I can't remember.
Ham, remind him.
Certainly, ma'am. 3:31. Mrs. Vermondo announced at the meeting that this year's annual reported budget of $29 billion had fallen short of expected interest quota charges in the second quarter to the tune of, at which point you, Mr. Beckwith, asked Mrs. Belmondo to, and I quote, hold on a sec.
I don't think I did.
With your permission, ma'am.
Certainly, ma'am.
All those who distinctly remember hearing Mr. Beckwith asking Mrs. Belmondo to hold on a sec, please raise their hands.
I'm sorry, ma'am. I was flustered. It just slipped out.
Beckwith, listen to me. I am Mrs. Margaret Belmondo, Chief Executive and Global Director of Transworld Trading, the most powerful commercial organization on Earth. What do you think would happen, Beckwith, if I was to make a practice of holding on a sec?
Yes, ma'am. Global catastrophe, ma'am.
Precisely. Do I look like the sort of person, Beckwith, to hold on a sec?
No, ma'am.
So what will you do to make amends?
Apologise.
What?
Apologise, ma'am.
No, Beckwith. You will not apologise. For you, it's the window.
No, ma'am, please. Not the window.
143 floors, Beckwith. And don't make a sound as you fall. It alarms the gardeners.
I'm sorry, ma'am. I won't get it wrong next time. Just give me one more
Beckwith,
chance.
You're holding up this meeting. You're costing the company money.
Right. Of course. The window.
Get a stool.
I would just like to say that I'm sorry for the mistakes.
Oh, get on with it, Beckwith.
Right. I won't hold up to you anymore. Good luck for the future, everyone.
Yes, yes. Off you go.
Right.
It's stuck.
Oh, come on, Beckwith. We weren't born yesterday. Stop playing for time.
Allow me, Mrs. Belmondo. Move out of the way, Beckwith. He's right, ma'am, just stop.
Call maintenance.
Sorry, ma'am. Maintenance? This is the chief executive's office. Please send someone up now. And I mean now. We have a stuck window situation.
Don't think you've gotten away with this, Beckwith. Stand over there and wait. And now, the future. When I think of the future, I see nothing but opportunity and growth. I see a world of money. I see unexplored markets waiting to be mapped. I see natural resources waiting to be tapped. I see financial targets waiting to be capped. I see our competitors waiting to be zapped. I see a world of expansion. I see... I see a dirty little man of a toolbox. What do you want? I said, what do you want?
The window, ma'am.
Yes, from the maintenance. He's come to fix the window.
Do you know this person?
No, ma'am. Never seen him before in our lives. He's just a maintenance man.
But he nodded to you.
Did he? Did he? Indeed. Thank you for pointing that out, ma'am. Now, listen here, Mr. Maintenance Man, whatever your name is. You don't go around nodding to senior executives who've never met you in their lives whenever you feel like it.
Well, get on with it. Beckwith, get ready.
that in a cardboard box.
Yes, I know that, but they don't know that, do they?
What?
For all they know, you might be a man of means.
What do you mean?
You know, means at your disposal, cash in your pockets, income.
I wouldn't be doing this if I had cash in my pockets.
Yes, I know that, but they don't know that, do they?
No. And I've got asthma.
Right. So you've got to express it in the way you stand. Show the doubt, the cold, the hunger.
The asthma.
Right. Focus on all the pain and the suffering.
Okay. The asthma.
Right. Look, here comes one. Spare us a glass of a cup of tea, Meg.
Why didn't she give you anything?
I know that.
She didn't give you anything. You said you were the best. You said you were an expert. You said stick with me and you'll be all right.
Look, don't rush things. Be patient. Focus on the damp, the cold, the hunger, the cardboard box,
the asthma.
Okay. Look, stay focused. Keep on. Spare us a glass of a cup of tea, mate. Right, that's it.
I'm sorry.
I've really tried with you.
Yeah, I know that.
But you just haven't got it, have you?
Not yet, but I'm trying.
Well, you can go try someone else because I'm done with you.
What? You want me to go?
Yes, off you go. Sod off, sling your rope, go away.
Well, I'll go then, shall I?
Yes, and stop looking so pathetic.
Sorry.
Because I got myself to think about, see? I'm just like all the rest, I don't care. And that's the first thing to learn this life. Nobody cares, right?
Yeah, right. Where do you think I should head? Maybe north, south? What do you think would be best?
South, north is all the same, I don't care.
Right. Well, I guess I'll head south. I've got a bus ticket.
What bus ticket?
I found it on the floor yesterday.
Look, yesterday's date.
Doesn't matter, does it?
Of course it matters, you can't use it.
Oh, well that's a bit disappointing. I guess I'll have to walk.
Oh, for God's sake, you're hopeless. You're absolutely friggin' hopeless. You'll die.
Will I?
Yeah. You'll just wander around in circles until you die. Oh, come here then.
Like you say.
One more day, and if nothing changes, then you're gone. Just stand there and don't do anything.
I'm hungry.
What am I to feel it on?
Oh, what you got?
You wait and see.
Go on.
Kit Kat, actually.
What, a big one?
Yeah.
A whole one?
Yeah.
Oh, give us a bit.
We'll get something to drink first.
And so I went straight up him and I said, why don't you take your head? Under a bus!
What does she want? I don't understand!
Apparently, she wants us to give her some money so that she can buy herself a cup of tea.
Are you a beggar?
Well, yes. Yes, I am.
Is it really horrid being a beggar?
Well, it's not very nice.
It doesn't look very nice. You all look cold and hungry.
Because I am cold and hungry.
And I've got asthma. Can I suggest something to you?
Yeah, be like,
why don't you stop being a beggar and be a businessman like my fiancé, Jacob?
Well,
because he has lots and lots of money and he never ever gets cold and hungry, do you, Jacob?
Absolutely never.
You see, it's the answer to all your problems.
Well, I just go down to the job centre and see if they have any openings for a successful businessman.
So, off you go, then.
Well, Well, I just need a price of a cup of tea. I think I'd have a better chance if I had a cup of tea.
Yes, I don't think you understood my brother. He's telling you to move on!
I'm just asking for the price.
We know what you're asking. We are telling you to leave.
Well, you can't tell me to leave. Yeah, we've got rights. Haven't we? Yeah, we've got rights.
Ham, they're being insolent! We don't like your tone, actually!
I don't like anything about you at all!
Yeah, well, I can cope with that, lady. I'm just asking for the price of a cup of tea.
Ham, do something! She's attacking me!
I'm not attacking her, I'm just asking her.
Leave this. Now, let's get this straight. You want a cup of tea, and you are asking us to give you the wherewithal for the aforesaid cup.
Yeah, I'm one for my mate.
Ah, two cups. But first it was one cup, and now the request has expanded, inflated, rocketed even, to the tune of two cups.
Two cups of tea is not a lot to ask.
You're sure you wouldn't like anything else? A buttered scone, perhaps?
Two cups of tea.
Some brandy snaps?
Two cups of tea.
Or perhaps you'd like my wife to run home and bake your little date and walnut cake?
Just give me money.
Got you.
What are you talking about?
No, oh, we've got you. Well, that was demanding money with menaces.
No, it wasn't.
Shem, remind me. What is the maximum sentence these days for demanding money with menaces?
8 years hard labour, I believe, Ham.
I wasn't menacing.
I think you'll find you were.
No, I wasn't, honest.
Well, I was menaced. I was utterly menaced. I've never been so menaced in all my life.
Witnesses, you see. Well, it looks to be something of a watertight case, doesn't it? Jabo, the police.
No, don't. Please. Sorry.
I beg your pardon.
I'm sorry.
I didn't quite hear that.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to menace you.
Yes, well, that simply won't do, will it? The damage has been done. These ladies have quite clearly been menaced.
And I'm sorry.
Yes, you don't understand. It's too late for being sorry. It's no good being sorry after the event.
I'll call the police then, shall I?
Oh, just one moment. It's just possible. I'm not promising anything. But it might just be possible for us to come to some sort of an arrangement. Settle this out of court, as it were.
What do you want?
Compensation.
Compensation?
Yes, compensation for the trauma which your criminal behavior has occasioned.
But I haven't got anything to give you.
Empty your pockets.
Look, I'm skinned. They're empty. I've got nothing.
Shem, try her jacket pockets. Oh, it's a Kit Kat.
I'm saving that.
We like Kit Kats, don't we, Japer?
Oh, rather. They're so sweet.
Not in the job when you're having a nice cup of tea,
Shall we go, ladies? Well, it's been so nice to meet you. Really, we must do this again soon. Good day.
I think I'm going to kill myself.
Yeah, me too.
Do you reckon it will hurt? You know, when you jump from a really tall building and you hit the ground, do you think it will hurt?
Probably. Everything else does. There is the price of a cup of tea, mate. Hey, look! A sandwich!
And coffee!
Cheers, mate. Thanks.
Yeah, real lifesaver.
Pity about the Kit Kat.
I don't think it would have tasted very nice.
Why is that?
Well, I nicked it off this bloke, but it was in his jacket pocket.
So?
Well, he'd been dead about 3 weeks now.
at night in the cities. We hear the mumbling voices of those who sit by fires under bridges. The air is full of sounds of crying and the sky black with smoke. Tanks stand ready in the deserts and machines prepared with poison rumble into open spaces. Lines of women with shaven heads stand waiting in stone corridors. Red scum and battery acid float downstream to the sewers of the sea. Rain burns the skin, explosions deafen the ears, black rubber torches shine in the faces of frightened children. The birds hide in the mountains, the forests are on fire, the polar ice caps turn to soup, and the whales all have cancer. The hungry watch in silence, whilst armed guards patrol vast warehouses filled to the rafters with cake.
What do you think? Not bad.
No, the report had to be clear. No, I think it's nicely done.
Distasteful, but nicely handled. I mean, you've seen Aurora and eyes. It's got a nice apocalyptic feel to it. You don't feel it's in any way over the top at all.
No, not at all. We've seen it with Aurora and eyes.
I did. Smell it too.
Yes, it's been quite a revelation. Then what's the problem? Let's just file a report and get out.
Can't be too soon for me. This place gives me the creeps.
So let's be clear. We recommend Oblivion.
Finito.
End of story. It all seems a bit final.
Look, don't take it so hard.
It's not our fault.
They had every opportunity to make something of it.
They just bugged it up. They've only got themselves to blame.
It could have been quite nice.
Well, it isn't.
Is it?
It's horrible.
It could have been wonderful.
And it will be.
One day.
Look, what we'll recommend is that they leave all the creatures under the hole in the planet for a few months.
Just till the dust settles.
All the mud dries in this case.
And then, beam all the creatures back, and they can carry on.
Nice, clean, little planet.
No humans.
Paradise? Yes. I suppose you're right. We don't have any choice, really, do we?
Of course we don't.
Look, May, I know how you feel. But it's a tricky business creation. Sometimes it just doesn't work out. Not quite getting all stewed up about it. It's a shame, but there you go.
So we're not recycling any human beings?
There's no point. We've looked, we've searched, they're fundamentally flawed, they're all evolved wrong.
They're too far gone. They can't even see angels anymore. Even now they can't even see us. That guidebook's out of date. They've evolved up into some other state. Not one person here has seen us.
We're talking about beings. No longer see angels?
I know. It's sad. We're invisible. Look at them. Look at them in the rain. The rain is their greatest blessing, their glory is how it all started.
And they curse it. They curse the rain.
And stand there, dripping like little black mushrooms. You're right. They're horrible. Let's file the report. We've done our best. I want to go home. He's looking at us. No, he's not. He's probably thinking, looking at something miles away.
He's probably mad or something.
He's looking at us.
That doesn't mean anything. Leave it.
He's looking at us. Can you see us? How many can you see? He can see us.
Come on, leave it.
It's hardly significant.
What do you want? Oh, look, he's giving us his umbrella.
Just a minute. I don't know how come you can see us. You must be some sort of primitive throwback or something. But we don't want to buy your umbrella.
And in any case, we're not permitted to carry any money.
Do you understand? We don't want to buy your...
He's trying to sell it to us. He's giving it to us. He doesn't want us to get wet. Thank you. Come on, we have to follow him.
Oh, for goodness sake. That's the time.
It's just one little man. No, hardly counts.
Be thorough. Be very thorough. And find me something worth saving.
I don't believe it.
We could have been home by Thursday. Quickly, we have to follow him.
Yes, all right.
more complicated than it already is. You know that, right? Can't we just pretend we didn't see them? No, I guess not.
Hurry up!
Oh, bugger!
He's very silent, isn't he?
Oh, yes, very silent. He's a man of vision, you see.
Quite brilliant.
An extraordinary talent.
And like all men of vision, he lives very much within himself.
Withdrawal.
Introvert.
A trifle eccentric, perhaps, but so, so brilliant. An extraordinary man.
Would he like a jacket?
Oh no, best not disturb him, dear. He's all right sitting there,
thinking his heart, sifting new ideas.
He's probably inventing something quite wonderful this very moment as we speak.
What does he actually make? Jacob was a bit vague.
It's complicated.
Difficult to explain.
Sort of unfathomable. But brilliant, so, so brilliant. You mustn't mind his silence, dear. It's just he's
a brilliant, utterly brilliant
personality that makes his behaviour so distinctive. Dear, dear man. Oh, Cynthia, perhaps you'd like to refill the teapot.
Oh, yes, I would love to. Where is it? Oh, yes, that one, of course. What do I fill up with?
Hot water would be nice.
Oh, yes. Hot water, of course. I won't be a moment.
Right, you spiteful little git. Sit up straight and listen to me. This is Japheth's new young lady, and she's been coming here for 3 weeks now, and you still haven't spoken to her. If you don't make some semblance of an effort to behave like a normal human being, you're going to spend the rest of the weekend in the shed.
That girl may well have the brain the size of a lentil, but her father is the first cousin of Miss Margaret Belmondo. Do you realise what that means? Japheth has gone through enormous trouble to...
anywhere. Have you tried the kitchen?
No.
I think there's an outside chance you'll strike lucky in the kitchen.
Lovely!
Jacob has gone through enormous trouble to secure this liaison, and if you foul it up for me, for him, then the consequences will be exceptionally unpleasant!
He gets worse!
He's become a liability!
It's intolerable!
I don't know why we put up with him!
He's utterly hopeless. You know he's lost his umbrella, don't you?
No.
Not the one you gave him!
Yes, the one I gave him. It just goes on and on. He's like a child. I've gotten used to him losing things. Coats go missing, scarves, hats, gloves, money sometimes. I'm used to all of that. This week he's already lost his thermos flask and his lunchbox. Things just disappear, don't they? Not a word of explanation. They just... disappear. But today was the last straw. He came home soaked to the skin because he'd lost his umbrella. And you know what he said when I asked him where it was? He said, I gave it to an angel.
An angel? He said he gave it to an angel.
Actually, he said there was three.
I found the hot water. Guess where it was?
Oh, surprise us.
It was in the kitchen. In the kettle. Now lost the teapot, I must have put it down somewhere.
Oh, never mind it, dear. Just stay and sit and get your breath back.
Oh, tell me more about Mr. Noah. He sounds terribly interesting.
It's him! We found him!
What's he doing now?
Oh, he's just thinking. Another brilliant idea has probably just arrived. You know, who knows where they come from. One minute he's just sitting there, and out of the blue, bang! A new idea.
Yes, that's definitely him.
Can you hear us?
He's nodding.
Oh, yes, he does this when it's an especially brilliant idea. You always do this, don't you, Noah?
Yes, but it's a very good sign.
Noah, his name's Noah. Did you hear? A question. Tell him we asked you.
What does he have to do?
You know, he's the one. There can't be any mistake. If it's going to be anyone, it's going to be him.
Right.
Here it goes.
Noah!
Mr. Noah.
Sorry.
Mr. Noah, can you see us?
He's waving.
Yes, waving means he.
It means he. Receiving the idea. He's acknowledging the new idea.
Oh, how exciting.
Mr. Noah, you don't happen to know anything about building a boat at all?
You don't happen to know how to build boats?
Ah, there's been a development, you see. He's become animated.
his little ritual.
His way of
acknowledging the importance of a new idea. It's a symbol.
Now, listen to us. There's going to be this great catastrophe. It's going to be a flood.
A mighty deluge.
Everybody's going to get drowned, actually.
Except you, of course.
And your family. You see, what you have to do is you have to build a boat. A great boat capable of standing the waves, the whirlwinds, and tides of flood. Will you do this for us, Noah? We come from God.
It's a multitude of angels, and they're playing with us.
Yes, God. Yes, God. He's finishing off right now. No, no problems. Well, this is it, God. It's going to be a lovely job. Yeah, he's a true craftsman. The bowl? It's a bit on the small side. It's not exactly huge. It's not exactly the Titanic, but then the Titanic didn't have heavenly protection, did it? Sorry. Oh, yeah, it's big enough to get his family on board. No problems there. Pardon? He wants to know if the family are okay.
What does he mean, okay?
What exactly do you mean by okay, God? He says, are they suitable?
Suitable? What are we saying?
Not exactly with you, God. Right.
He says, are they appropriate for our purposes?
Well, it's too late to do anything about it if they're not.
We have to press on. We can't start changing the passengers now.
Yeah. We're fairly confident about the appropriateness, God. Three strapping sons.
All married. Tell him they're all married. One of them's not married. He's only engaged.
Never mind about that. That doesn't matter under these circumstances. Yes, yes, they're all married. Lovely wives. No problems about repopulation there, I wouldn't have thought. Yes, he's married too. His wife? Well, she's charming. Slightly forthright and emphatic, but certainly not without charm. Yes? Yes, we understand that, God. Yes, we realize how important. Yes, yes, we understand. Yes, we take full responsibility for the selection process. Yes. Yes, we know. The legend must stress the importance of the family unit. Quite. What? He wants to know what the weather's doing. Wow, it's been getting darker and more stormy recently. Oh my, it's you, isn't it? Oh. Conditions are going to gradually worsen over the weekend, culminating in a tidal wave sometime on Sunday night. Fine. We'll be... sure. Noah? God wants a word? It's all right. Just press this button and he'll come through on vision.
Noah? I can see you, Noah. Noah? It's coming soon. You must be strong. You must stand firm. The boat will not break, Noah. However fierce the storm, however wild the seas, however tall the tidal wave, the boat will not break. You have my word. But you, will you be strong enough? Will you break? When they start coming at you, when they start crying out for help, pleading, crawling on their hands and knees, begging for salvation, what will you do, Noah? Will you be strong enough?
I don't know.
Then you'll find out, Noah. You'll find out on Sunday night. Be ready.
What'd you say that for? What? I don't know, supposed to mean!
You might at least sounded confident.
Look, mate, our reputations are resting on this one.
If this goes wrong, we could be demoted to desk jobs for the next 1,000 years!
I've got a bad feeling about this. It's getting darker.
It's coming from the west. There's nothing we can do to stop it now.
You better get this right now. You better get it right.
Now, I don't know what you think you're doing up there, Noah, but I want you down and back in this house this minute. Do you understand? Tell him.
Father, this is getting embarrassing. People are laughing at you. They're laughing at us.
He's just showing off. Some sort of grand gesture.
He's finally flipped. Look at him. He's not even listening.
Please, Father. The motor boats were one thing. I mean, everyone needs a little bit of a hobby. We understand about that. But this, altogether, it's different, isn't it? Well, this. It's a proper boat, isn't it?
Oh, it's taking up the whole garden! It's ruined the roses! It hasn't even got planning permission! And while we're at it, where's your bicycle?
he's lost his bike now.
If Mrs. Belmondo gets to hear about this, it could seriously undermine our position in the company.
If you don't come down right now, I'm coming up. I'll drag him down.
Oh. Jacob, please. We agreed no violence at this stage. Look, Father, is this something to do with these angels, is it? There's nothing wrong with that, is there? I mean, lots of people see angels.
No, they don't. Nobody sees bloody angels. He's the only man.
Jacob, please, leave this to your brother.
Lots of people see angels. And I expect these angels sort of suggested that you might like to have a go at building a boat, did they? And why not? Nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with that at all. But I think it might be a good idea if you came down after the rain and told us all about it indoors. We can have a nice cup of tea.
And some cake!
No, that's okay. And you can change some dry things.
Then we can call the bloody psychiatrist!
Jacob, please! Yes, we did think you might like to have a little chat with a doctor friend of ours. He's very interested in angels. You can tell him all about them, only if you feel like it, of course.
Oh, it's no use, he's not listening. Oh God, look, neighbours! Pam, get rid of them.
I'm sure you're all wondering what this boat is doing in my father's front garden. Oh. Well, he's built it.
For charity! Yes,
for charity. And he's going to auction it, and the money will go to
various charities!
Toys, exactly. But the auction won't actually be until next week, so perhaps these people just like to bugger off.
I'd like to start bidding now.
Oh, it's Miss Belmondo! Ham, do something!
Hello, Ham, Shem, Japheth. What a horrible evening! What terrible weather!
Yes, very unpleasant. Can I help you, Mrs. Belmondo?
Certainly, Ham. Japheth, take my luggage and pull it on the boat.
Why, certainly, Mrs. Belmondo. Wait, did you say put it on the boat?
Yes, I'm coming with you.
With us?
Where?
Oh, you can stop pretending now. I know all about it.
All about what? Ham, what's going on?
I've no idea, Mother.
Look, I'd have certainly done the same thing myself if I was in your position.
What position?
We don't understand.
I'm beginning to lose my patience with you. There's not much time.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Belmondo. We're still not quite sure what you're getting at.
Transworld Trading has the most powerful telecommunication in the world. We have the capacity to overhear, with perfect clarity, phone call conversations anywhere on this planet, and occasionally from beyond. Am I making myself clear?
not exactly, no.
On Friday night, my people intercepted a call made to your father. A very unusual frequency. Rather disturbing message, wasn't it, Noah?
What's all this about, Noah? Who's been phoning you up?
And today, my weather people reported the development of, shall we say, unconventional weather patterns. It all falls into place. So if you'll just stow my luggage on the boat and I shall get aboard. Is there a first class cabin or is one expected to rock?
Now, just a minute. This has gone far enough. I really must ask for an explanation. What are you talking about? he's just a little bit tired, is all. A bit eccentric. The boat is just his little joke. Mrs. Belmondo, with the greatest respect, I don't still understand what you're doing.
He hasn't told you, has he?
Told us what?
He was going to leave without you.
And go where?
Tell me, Noah. I'm interested. These angels, what exactly did they look like?
She's talking about angels!
You mean he really has seen angels?
There are three as far as I can count.
Oh, and the phone call.
From...
And the weather conditions?
imminent.
And the boat?
Yes, the boat.
I'm sorry. I'm really sorry.